Hey guys, it's Jen. Welcome back to Joyful Living. Welcome to my dining room. I think I've only done one other video in here, but I'm coming to you today from my dining room because we are going to be talking about Thanksgiving. And I do feel a little bit like Thanksgiving gets kind of just mowed right over, doesn't it? We have Halloween and we have Christmas, and poor Thanksgiving is just sitting there going, hey guys, hey. Thanksgiving and I have a long and storied tradition. I have cooked over 20 Thanksgiving dinners in my 30 years of marriage. I have cooked Thanksgiving dinner for 2 people and I have cooked it for 16 people. And yes, I am a vegetarian, and yes, I do cook a turkey every Thanksgiving. I'm sorry, turkeys. Wasn't always a vegetarian, so some of those years I had an excuse, but oh my goodness, poor turkeys. If you are hosting Thanksgiving, and maybe it's your first time hosting Thanksgiving, you might have a little bit of going on inside because there's a lot of pressure on this meal, right? I mean, people are gonna come to your house and they have high expectations of a classic Thanksgiving meal, and it's family. So you want everybody to get along and you don't want anything to burn and you want the kids to be well behaved and you want your house to be perfectly clean and you want to be the house that hosts the Thanksgiving that people will be talking about for years to come. Let's get real. That is not going to happen. But if you put in some work ahead of time, and if you listen to my tips, you might find that you actually have a really nice day where you can eat some good food and be grateful. And that's really all we should expect from this poor little Thursday in November. She's doing the best she can. Tip number one, and if you listen to nothing else, listen to tip number one. Oh, and then listen to my mashed potato tip. That's going to be a bonus tip at the very end. That might be the most important. But tip number one is important too. Tip number one. Be realistic. If you are not a fabulous chef, do not try to cook 15 different things. Do not try to do 3 mains and 6 sides and 4 desserts. Do not try to make dishes that you watch somebody make on the Food Network and you don't even know what half the ingredients are called. Please know yourself, know your capabilities as a chef, and keep it simple. What I usually do is about 3 weeks before Thanksgiving, so about right now, I'm gonna write out my perfect menu and then I'm gonna cross out a bunch of stuff that's either too much work or nobody really eats or is too expensive to make. Just remember that nobody is gonna miss it if it's not on the table. And if it's that, you know, weird critical aunt of yours that brings up that something's missing, then present to her the idea of hosting Thanksgiving at her house next year. Tip number 2, do as much ahead as humanly possible. I know a lot of you watching this are also working full time. This was me as well. So you really only have your weekends and your weeknights, but try to break things down into manageable pieces. Think about things like making sure you have enough silverware and dishes and serving pieces. Do you need to borrow something from a neighbor? I find a lot of times your neighbors aren't all hosting Thanksgiving as well. So that's a great option because you really don't want to have enough things to serve 16 people on a regular basis. That's just silly. So borrow what you can. Make sure you have enough to-go containers. See if you can afford to have someone come and clean your house, especially if you are hosting. I realize that that is an added expense, but if you're working full-time, you've got little kids to take care of, and you're hosting Thanksgiving, also getting your house in picture perfect condition might be asking a little bit too much. So that's another thing that you could outsource in advance. Also, a few days before, you can start making things. I always make ahead my sweet potato casserole. I usually make ahead my mashed potatoes, tip coming at the very end. I always would set my table at the very least the night before. Anything and everything that can be done in advance, do it. You will save yourself so much stress and anxiety on the actual day itself, which especially once people start coming, it's just chaos, y'all. I know that nobody wants chaos, but it's chaos. And hopefully it's happy chaos, but you know, chaos. Tip number 3. And this one, I'm sorry that I have to say, and I find it very annoying, but the reality is children are going to need to eat and not just that one meal on Thanksgiving Day. I never understood it either. I would be in my kitchen happily cooking away and some random 4-year-old, who was typically one of mine, would wander into the kitchen and ask what was for lunch. What's for lunch? It's Thanksgiving. I'm cooking. Why do you need lunch? Well, small children tend to want to eat more than once a day, and it doesn't seem to matter if you fed them the day before, they still want to eat. So make sure you've made a plan for the feeding of your children. Now, my favorite thing here is to do something like, you know, a grab and go type situation, like Lunchables. Or maybe even have your significant other take them to a takeout restaurant, like McDonald's. They are not going to die, and what we really don't want is someone in the kitchen trying to make nachos at 1 o'clock when your kitchen is filled with all kinds of wonderful things happening. I don't need that. I don't need that, nor do I want that. I really don't want you in my kitchen unless you're cooking, pouring me wine, keeping me company, or doing the dishes. I don't know why else you would be in there on Thanksgiving Day. And while we are on the topic of young children, please try to enlist someone else to take care of your precious angels while you are trying to cook Thanksgiving dinner. And I mean really take care of them. I mean really take care of them. I want you to be able to focus solely on getting that beautiful meal on the table. And we really want the kids to still be alive at the end of the day. So please delegate the care of your kids to somebody else. Tip number 4, do the dishes as you go. Now, I realize this seems a little obvious, but you know the whole thing about being a clean chef. It's so important on Thanksgiving. Load, run, and unload the dishwasher as you go. Fill one part of the sink with warm soapy water. Then you can just put dishes in there as you dirty them. That tip was given to me by my wonderful mother-in-law, Shirley, who has passed away, but she was really good at keeping a clean kitchen. So honestly, by the time we sat down to eat, the only dishes we had to worry about were the ones that we were actually using for the Thanksgiving meal itself. That's something that I've adopted as well, and it really goes a long way towards ensuring just kind of a more chilled out day. Also, I don't know about you, but I never had enough measuring bowls and spoons and all of that that I could just not have to reuse things. So having that warm soapy water ensures that it's really easy to reuse what you need to reuse. It's very practical, but it's one of those things that until you really think it through, you might neglect to do it, and then you end up with a huge mound of dishes, and that's just no fun. I don't like that at all. And then lastly, tip number 5, by the time you sit down for that beautifully prepared meal, I want you, my dear, to be done for the day. Now, I know that you have put so much work into this, and I know that you have these guests and you hate for them to have to work, but guess what? You don't need to do anything else today. I want you wherever you're most comfortable, whether that be in your bedroom, in the family room, in front of the fire, watching a movie, watching football, I don't care. I want your feet up. I want a beverage of your choice in your hands, and I want someone else to do those dishes. You have worked hard, and I'm really proud of you. Okay, you made it all the way to the end. So I'm going to give you my super secret mashed potato tip. Yay! Now, if you have heard this before, humor me and pretend like this is blowing your mind, but mashed potatoes work really well if you reheat them in the crock pot. So you can make them ahead, reheat them in the crock pot, add a little bit more butter or milk if you need to, or you can also do heavy cream. Some people do that because, you know, it's a feast day, it's Thanksgiving, you can do whatever you want. And then, this is the best part. Once they're piping hot, leave them in the crock pot on warm and plug the crock pot in your dining room, because you know what happens? Everybody wants seconds of mashed potatoes, but nobody wants them to be cold. So if you keep the crock pot in the dining room, guess what you're gonna have? Piping hot, beautiful mashed potatoes, and everybody can have seconds, or thirds, or fourths, or whatever it is that you like. I hope that as you and your family gather around the table this year, that one of the gifts that they can be grateful for is that the person who made the meal was not stressed out, was not freaking out, but rather had a lovely day where she or he could really enjoy every minute with family and friends. Don't forget the reason for this holiday. Don't skip this holiday. Let's not just go straight to Christmas this year. Let's slow down. Let's give Thanksgiving its due. And I hope that you and your family family have a fabulous day, and I hope that it brings you joy. Please make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a big thumbs up, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.